Have you heard how young Albert Ramsbottom was evacuated from home with his mother, clean socks and a toothbrush, some syrup of figs and a comb? The stick with the horse's head handle, they decided that they'd leave behind to keep safe with the things they weren't wanting, like their gas masks and things of that kind. Pa saw them off at the station and shed a few crocodile's tears as he waved them goodbye from the platform. 'Twas the best break he'd had in 10 years. Ma got corner seat for young Albert, who amused all the rest of the team by breathing hot breaths on the window and writing some swear words in steam. They arrived at last somewhere in England, and straight to their billet were shown. There was one room for mother, but Albert was in a small room of his own. The very first night in the blackout, young Albert performed quite a feat by hanging head first from the window and shining his torch down the street. It flashed on an ARP warden patrolling with leisurely gait. "Good heavens," said he, "it's Tarzan. I better go investigate." So reading his book of instructions to make himself doubly sure, then in an official manner proceeded to knock on the door. It was opened by Mrs. Ramsbottom.
"Now then," said she, "what's to do?"
And in a stern air warden manner he said,
"I'm going to interrogate you."
This fair upset Mrs. Ramsbottom. Her face was a picture to see.
"I'll have you know you'll do nought of the sort. I'm a respectable woman," said she.
"Has your son been evacuated?"
said the ARP man at the door.
"He'd all them things done as a baby," said mother. "He's not being done any more." "Be off now," said Mrs. Ramsbottom, as she bustled him out of the porch. And the ARP man patted Albert and then confiscated his torch. Now, that were unlucky for Albert. He had no torch to see him to bed. But being a bright little fella, he switched on the all light instead.
"Put out that light," a voice shouted. "Where's the men of our ARP?"
"I've told them already," the warden replied. "They take no ruddy notice of me." Soon Mrs. Ramsbottom and Albert were feeling quite homesick and sad, so they thanked the landlady most kindly and prepared to go back home to Dad. When at last they reached home to Father, they were fed up and had quite enough. But in the front parlour they found 6 young women, and Father were doing his stuff.
"Hello, Mother," said Mr. Ramsbottom. "Come right on in, don't be afraid. When you went away, I joined ambulance corps. I'm instructing the girls in first aid."
"First aid," said Mrs. Ramsbottom, with a horrible look on her brow. "If ever you wanted first aid in your life, by gum, you'll be wanting it now."